trigonometry, in the last class we discussed about how they given one function and ask for another function. Similar problem to that one. If they given one function with a cumulative manner, means one numerical value to the left side also if we have. Means if 3 tan A equal to 4, it means 3 into it is. Then find sin A and cos A, or then ask tan cosec like that. But here already tan given, if they ask cot directly, we can take reciprocal. That's why they given sin A and cos A asking. See, from that given thing, if you transpose 3 to opposite side, that become tan A equal to 4 by 3. Then we know that the function of tan is what? Opposite side by adjacent side. Here at which word takes, means at which acute angle, that is A, tan A. We don't know that remaining two vertices of a triangle, let us consider right angle triangle, whatever it is, but acute angle is A. If I consider acute angle here, they have given opposite and adjacent. We know that trigonometric ratios, nothing but ratio between the sides, that is ratio, not a fixed value. That's why that ratio value we are taking in terms of K. Nothing but 4, nothing but 4K, 3, nothing but 3K. If we remove KK, you will get only 4 by 3. That nothing but it is 4 by 3. Means we have opposite as 4K, adjacent as 3K. We have two sides, then we know that already trigonometric ratio is applicable only in right angle triangle. That's why if you know any two of the sides, we can find another side. That another side is nothing but here hypotenuse. So we are finding hypotenuse because of this right angle triangle, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. So by that Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square equal to side square plus side square, those two sides are here named as opposite and adjacent. So opposite square plus adjacent square. Opposite is what? 4k square, adjacent is 3k square. 4k square nothing but 16k square, 3k square nothing but 9k square. So totally 25k square. From this hypotenuse, we need only hypotenuse. If you transpose square to opposite, that becomes square root. Again, 25 nothing but 5 whole square. K square already we have that K whole square. Combined we are writing 5K whole square. Square and root get cancelled, you will get only 5K. Finally, we have got hypotenuse value as 5K. Now we have got three sides, opposites, adjacent and hypotenuse. Now we are finding the question and values what they have asked for, sin A and cos A. Now, sin A. What is the main function of sin A? Opposite by hypotenuse. So, opposite value already given. Hypotenuse we have found out, that is 4k opposite, hypotenuse is 5k. Already we stated this is only sides ratio, kk get cancelled, you will get 4 by 5. Now coming to another one, cos A. Cos A function is adjacent by hypotenuse. So adjacent value given as 3k by 5k, kk get cancelled, you will get 3 by 5. So these are the values of sin A and cos A. So this is a problem based, they will given for 2 marks or 1 mark, they will give one trigonometry function and they will ask for another trigonometry function. Next, coming to another problem, this is a different type of problem. They may ask for 4 marks problem. This is 4 marks. Let us see, in triangle ABC and triangle XYZ, means two triangles they have mentioned, angle A and angle X are acute angles. Angle A and angle X are acute angles such that cos A equal to cos X ra. Means what does it mean? Cos A means in first triangle cos function and in the second triangle cos X function, acute angles A and X. Then if this condition given to you, then show that angle A equal to angle X, nothing but acute angles of first triangle and second triangle of A and X are equal. That is the thing we need to prove. So let us consider two triangles. If they mentioned cos A and cos X, means trigonometric functions applied, nothing but indirectly they are right angle triangles. So where is that right angle, we don't know exactly, but you just consider angle A, X are acute angles. So in that manner I am taking like this. So let us consider two triangles naming them as A, B, C and X, Y, Z. So now see, angle A and angle X are acute angles. Now what are they given? Given that cos A equals to cos X. Cos A at acute angle A, at acute angle X. But whatever acute angle, we know main functions for cos is what? Adjacent by hypotenuse. So adjacent by cos value, adjacent by hypotenuse, cos function. Let us see in this triangle for A, what is adjacent? AB. And cos function hypotenuse, what is hypotenuse? AC. Here AC is also adjacent to A, but it is hypotenuse because opposite to right angle. That's why adjacent is only AB. what is adjacent to xy, but not to xz because it is hypotenuse. What is that? We can take xy divided by xz. So we have got AB by AC equal to xy by xz. What does it mean? Means the sides ratio of two triangles are same. Same to what value we don't know, but if it is some 3, it is also 3. It is some 5 by 7, it is also 5 by 7. Like that, let us assume that value as some k. Let us assume that. Say, for our convenience, we are taking. So, we have to prove angle A equal to angle extra. So, here we have got sides ratio of 2 to sides. We left one, means we have left one more side. That is what here? AB, AC we have. And here XY, XZ we have. Another corresponding sides we have. No? Let us consider them. What is that? BC. And here YZ. Means in triangle, first triangle, ABC, in this triangle, angle B is 90 degree. What is hypotenuse? AC. So, if you take, from this, if you take, it is equal to K without taking. Let us take here side BC, find for BC. We are finding for BC. To find that, apply Pythagoras theorem in it. What is that? AC square equals to AB square plus BC square. We need BC square. So let us transpose AB square to opposite side. Means BC square as it is to the right side. Then AC square minus AB square. We are getting this one. Similarly, in the next triangle also, in triangle XYZ, angle Y is 90 degree. Angle Y is 90. Let us take XZ whole square equals to XY whole square plus YZ whole square. Because by Pythagoras theorem, XZ by hypotenuse equals sum of the squares of these two sides. Now we need to find only this side because here we missed that side. That side is what YZ. Triangle into left side. XZ whole square minus XY whole square equal to YZ whole square. YZ whole square. So here we have got one condition by the given condition. Let us assume it as equation 1 and use this condition in these situations. How? Let us see here. To find the difference between these two are different sides. Let us convert them into similar sides. To convert that from 1 means from equation 1. Let us see here what we have got. AB by AC equal to K. No? Let us write that AB by AC equals to K in this triangle. Similarly, from 1, here also XY by XZ equal to K regarding that second triangle. Now see, from this what will we get? AB equal to, if you transpose AC to opposite side, it will become multiplication. So K into AC. Now here also, from this XY equal to, transpose it to opposite side, K into XZ. Substitute these two in these conditions. So let us write here. What is that? AC square, no? So AC square. Minus AB square, AB means we have got K into AC. Means K dot K into AC whole square. If we square separate it, so you will get like this K square AC square is equals to what? BC square. Let us write BC whole square. See here AC square common. Let us take common. Then you will get what? Here 1. Because as it is common, if you take common, you will get 1 minus K square equal to BC whole square. Now see here. Try to square to opposite side and write this condition reversely. BC square equals to AC square into 1 minus K square. Now try to square to opposite side. BC equals to square root of AC square into 1 minus K square. Now separate square two terms means root AC square into root 1 minus K square. Now square root cancel. Therefore, you will get BC as AC into square root 1 minus K square. This is in the first triangle side BC value we have. Similarly, corresponding side in this triangle is what? YZ. Let us find it from this condition. I am writing it as reversely. That is what? YZ square equals to XZ whole square. But XZ minus XY. In this XY in terms of XZ we are getting. So, write that XZ whole square minus XY nothing but what? K into XZ whole square, separate square two terms. Now in this common x z square means x z whole square, you will get 1 minus k square, because x z whole square, x will come 1 minus k square. Now transpose this square to opposite side, then you will get only y z as square root x z whole square into 1 minus k square. So now root x z whole square into root 1 minus k square, square root will cancel, you will get finally x z into square root 1 minus k square. That is the value of corresponding side of BC YZ in the next triangle. Now you have to take sides ratio in BC and means in the first triangle and in the second triangle BC by YZ equal to what will you get? Get after getting BC and YZ here, let us take sides ratio BC by YZ equals to BC nothing but AC into square root 1 minus K square by XZ into square root 1 minus K square. Now 1 minus k square, 1 minus k get cancelled. You will get AC divided by XZ. AC by XZ. Let us take BC by YZ equal to AC by XZ as observation 2. That is 1. Once recall 1, what is that? From 1, AB by AC equals to XY by XZ. Rearrange it. Implies, if you rearrange it, what will we get? Let us see. AB. Transpose it to opposite side in the place of AC, that become XY, and AC in place of XY, that become AC by XZ. Let us observation 3. Now 3, if you observe from 2 and 3, AC by XZ, AC by XZ means if the right side parts are equal, automatically left side parts are also to be equal. Combining these 3 parts are equal means let us write AB by XY equals to BC by YZ equals to AC by XZ. These two are equal to AC by XZ. If we observe this condition, see AB, AB divided by XY means corresponding side in the second triangle. Next BC, what is that? BC corresponding side in the next triangle is what? YZ, YZ. Next hypotenuse is AC, next hypotenuse in this is XZ. These three sides ratios are same. Three sides ratios of two different sides. Triangles corresponding size ratio are same, then they are said to be what? Similar triangles. As per similarity of the criteria, if the corresponding sides ratio of two different triangles are same, then those triangles are said to be similar. Means triangle ABC is similar to triangle XYZ. Means two triangles are similar because of the sides ratio is same. So, if the two triangles are similar, automatically is what? Angles are equal. Means, angle A equal to angle X, angle B equal to angle Y, angle C equal to angle Z. Accurate angles. But here they are asking only one condition regarding one, two triangle. Two angles, what are there? Two actual angles, angle A equal to angle X. Therefore, because of this condition, we can write that therefore, angle A equal to angle X. That is the thing we have to prove. So, hence proved by based upon the similarity of two triangles. Why? How can we say that those two are similar? Because of the sides ratio is same. That's why we can take angle, triangles are similar, then their angles are equal. This is the problem based upon similarity criteria. And if the two functions of two different triangles are equal, then prove that their acute angles are equal. These two are two different problems. So, be concentrated on it and do the problems related to this regarding exercise 11.